If and when the Cavs win a championship, will you consider your mission done and leave us? Or are you going to stick around?
I got a goal, and that's a huge goal, and that's to bring an NBA championship here to Cleveland, and I won't stop till I get it.
When we win an NBA championship, my mission will not be done.
Bagged out.
If I ever win a ring, I'll be very emotional.
The Dallas Mavericks are NBA champions.
I don't think, at the end of the day, rings doesn't always define someone's career.
He's not gifted enough as far as like knowing how to bring his other players in with him.
When things get difficult, you fight.
I was furious at you. You don't care, do you?
That's your legacy.
Give me one. I just want one.
The Cavaliers will win an NBA championship before LeBron does.
Nobody cares about the Miami Heat. You bought all this stuff on yourself.
The biggest flopping team in the NBA.
When you make mistakes, it's how you come back from adversity. It's how you come back from those pitfalls that define who you are as a man.
I think I was born with the ability to lead in other ways than just basketball.
I guess I'm on my biggest critic.
We're watching LeBron do what he's doing right now. Where he takes it, we don't know.
I know you guys talk here when you say this, but I got better.
You know, I think I'm here for more than just to play the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, stand to your feet and greet the greatest player in the world.
Set it off, broken glass in the hallway, bloodstained floors, neighbors, look at every bag you bring through your doors, lock the top lock, mama should've cuffed me to the radiator, why not, it might've saved me later from my block and why cops, hookers crawling off the stroke, coughing stitches in they head, stinking and I dread thinking they be snitching, but who else could it be, Shook of D's, I'm Mark Vans, parked in the dark, Knox, where's your heart, hustle or starve, they bust a UE, I jog, all of a sudden we got Crips and Bloods, DT's running around quick to split your mug, it's easy to score, but it's hard to get your shit off, niggas fighting over 100 cells, jumping the car, drive off, a lot of niggas scheming, some real, some niggas fronting, but I'm a big dreamer, so watch me come up with something.
Rosé is in the neighborhood, man, and before we get into anything, man, NBA, basketball,
right.
you saw the so-called greatness in LeBron James when we were all still kind of hating. Yeah.
I got a certain vision.
Right. Who's the best in the NBA, man, for real, individually, as a basketball player? Man, come on, man.
Answer honestly.
He been to the finals the last three seasons in a row. What you mean is LeBron James.
LeBron James.
You have to watch out for new legends. Like, nobody has to make room. You got to earn everything you get, you know what I mean? Nobody just going to stamp you a legend and you're not doing anything that's legendary. But it's a caution to the people who are watching or still reminiscing on the Jordans, you know what I mean? Like, yo, LeBron James exists, you know what I mean? Like, there's people out there that will ride so hard for Jordan that they denying how amazing LeBron James is, you know what I mean?
Teams go to the finals a year.
Doesn't matter. It's about winning.
Two teams go to the finals every year. LeBron's been there twice. Give my man some credit.
The thing about LeBron James that I really love is that he's inclusive. A lot of times when you're one of the top players on your team, one of the top players in the league, maybe you're about offense, maybe you're about a segment of the game. He makes players around him better. Plus, you look down at the stat sheet, he's shooting 60% and getting you 30.
He's on fire. He's in fuego. And because he's on fire, you're right. He makes his teammates better. You know, Mike Miller, who plays with the Memphis Grizzlies now, he's not going to be as good without LeBron James. Ray Allen is better with LeBron James. Shane Battier is better because of LeBron James. He's very inclusive. He's on fire. He makes everybody else better.
You blow my mind, the talent that you have. You're unbelievable. And also, too, now you're, I think, the smartest player in the game, too, as well. LeBron, and I'm serious, too. You know, I've seen everybody, but you are the only guy, I think, that can become the greatest that's ever played this game.
Too much, too soon. And that doesn't just apply to LeBron James. It applies to all these kids now. Culturally, I don't know how any kid can be ready for this. You know that Adidas and Nike are apparently at war over this kid already?
He may only be a sophomore in high school, but LeBron James is already one of the most highly touted basketball players in the country. The 6'6" superstar from Akron St. Vincent St. Mary's has captured the attention of fans, scouts, and opponents. James has a knack for making the game look breathtakingly effortless.
With the first pick in the 2003 NBA draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select LeBron James.
Arco Arena in Sacramento. The site of the season opener, the much anticipated debut of one LeBron James. Sacramento, a winner, 106-92 is the final.
You know, I think I could have helped my team a little bit more, you know, down the stretch. You know, I think, you know, once they start making a run, I could have been a little bit more aggressive.
When I look at myself, I'm not just representing LeBron now. You know, I'm representing the NBA, the Cavaliers, the city of Akron, you know, city of Cleveland. So I'm up for a lot of people, so I'm not going to disappoint anybody.
Flight number 23. Cavaliers got a foul. Ripped away, though. James to push it. LeBron James, he's got it. And LeBron with the left hand. How about that? LeBron James, look out. Taking off and touching down.
I can play this game. All the hype came in because I put the ball in the basket. You know, if I didn't play as well as I did, none of the cameras or none of the media hype would have been there.
Blocked by LeBron! That basketball will never be the same! Incredible! Don't bring that Greek stuff in here!
Watch it!
We're seeing competitive greatness from LeBron James.
I'd be able to play against anybody. And I'm here for a reason.
And another jumper. Right. Oh, my goodness.
I'm not looking for myself all the time. I think my game is very unselfish. You know, I got teammates. You know, it's always the four other players on the court.
And taking to the rim.
Tell us how much you weigh, because LeBron, I've never seen anybody like you. You can jump, you're fast, you're quick, you can handle the ball. So how tall are you and how big are you?
Well, last time I was about 6'8", and you know, everyone trying to know how much I weigh. I'm about, you know, we look at like 250 plus. Yeah. I'm like 250 plus.
And you like laying the wood on people, don't you?
Well, to me, it's a no-brainer. It's LeBron James. He plays like he's a wild card player. He can play four positions if you ask him to do so. And his ability to get everyone involved in the game is just remarkable for someone his age. I also think that if you look at basketball today, it's not always the big guys who win for you. It's the intermediate-sized guys. LeBron James is a big guy. I mean, he's 6'8", 260, incredible skill, great. I don't know if there's a better athlete that I've ever seen play professional basketball.
The Cavs lost three straight, and again, the impending free agency of LeBron James sends the impact of this collapse to another dimension. If he leaves, it would be a disaster of enormous proportions for the Cavaliers. There will be big changes for the Cavaliers as they fall short once again.
$171.92.
But that newfound prosperity and self-esteem has a fragile foundation, one that is shaken every time someone brings up 2010, the year James becomes a free agent and could abandon Cleveland.
Cleveland doesn't need another letdown. Cleveland desperately needs a winner.
How would it make Clevelanders feel if LeBron would somehow leave for what he might think are greener pastures?
I don't know.
How would they feel about themselves? They'd be crushed. They would be crushed.
What would the nation think of Cleveland if LeBron leaves for a bigger pasture?
They'd just say another mistake on the lake.
How did Cleveland fans take it when LeBron, of all people, wore a Yankees hat during a playoff game?
People were not real happy overall that he wore a Yankees hat. No secret. He's a Yankees fan. It definitely was a lightning rod for a period where the people got pretty passionate about it.
If he leaves us, it's going to take our hearts.
Forget about LeBron. You got to take that jersey off or I'm going to beat you up.
Hey, LeBron.
You love like a cow.
Fraud at the city of Cleveland.
You'll sell out.
The Cavs would be great without LeBron.
We're going to be better without you.
You are now Art Modell.
They hate you.
LeBron James is the most hated man in Cleveland, Ohio.
Because we hate you, LeBron.
For seven seasons, LeBron James wore the colors of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Then came the decision. And tonight comes the return. And moments ago, he took to the court in Cleveland.
I've been in two NBA finals, and I've not seen the electricity in a regular season game ever in my life. I've been around basketball for 25 to 30 years and have never seen an electricity in a building and the intensity in a building for a regular season game. This feels like the NBA Finals right now. It's not a game, like I said, it's like a Game 7.
Does it bother you that so many people are happy to see you fail?
Absolutely not. Because at the end of the day, all the people that was rooting on me to fail, you know, at the end of the day, they got to wake up tomorrow and have the same life that they had before they woke up today. You know, they got the same personal problems that they had today. You know, and I'm going to continue to live the way I want to live and continue to do the things that I want to do. You know, they can get a few days or a few months or whatever the case may be. You know, they got to get back to the real world at some point.
Going to these playoffs now, a whole lot of people are of the opinion that anything less than a title right now means failure for you guys. LeBron, do you believe that as much as you want to win? Do you believe to that degree?
Well, I think it's a bunch of teams that's in the postseason right now that, you know, if they don't win the title, then it's a failure. You know, that's how we're looking at it. We're looking at it like we want to win the title right now.
Come on, man. Oh, have some balls. LeBron, at times this season, it seemed you embraced that whole villain role, which we've argued about, Tony and I, back and forth. And I keep saying, you are not a villain. This is not who you are, but you did seem to embrace it. Why did you?
Well, for me, when I say that I embraced the villain role, you know, it's about, you know, just trying to take advantage of, you know, the fans and bringing more light on me so it can take it away from my teammates.
There he goes. Oh! The House of Highlights!
You think these guys like passing the ball to each other? Wow.
obviously we got some Texas people here. This was the Mavericks' first title, so I want to start by recognizing everybody who stuck with the team through good times and through bad. Give it up for the Dallas Mavericks. Dirk, you got something for me? Come on. All right. That's it. That's what I'm talking about.
That's it. I heard your
victory. Thank you so much. Well, you know, I was actually, I was 23 before Jordan.
Oh, you were?
I was. So he got the number from me.
Stole it.
That's what happened. That's beautiful. So I think we're going to take a picture. You guys going to break this down?
A stunning ending to one of the more compelling seasons in NBA history.
Hey, it's
going to
beat up a little bit.
Is it even a question?
Just selfish.
Miami.
You would leave us? What happened to family?
You bagged out.
Maybe I should just disappear.
Hey, yo.
But on an emotional level, are you hurt by this? Because it is the first time this has happened to you. And surely it must hurt a little.
We've supported him for 7 years now, and for him to go on there and drag us through the mud for 7 years and stab us in the heart, he deserves everything he gets.
I don't know if I like that question. It's you know, we hear that a lot. You know, it's never, what is it about, you know, the Miami Heat that make it tough on other teams. It's always, you know, the Bulls or the Pacers or the Knicks or whatever the case may be. You know, teams make it tough on us, we make it tough on them.
I love the news writers and the headlines.
Yeah.
LeBron, Lagan. I love them.
Yeah.
I love their headlines.
Just to write down some of the words used by Dan Gilbert when this all went down a few years ago: cowardly, betrayal, shameful, callous, selfish, disloyal, heartless. And that's just the first couple paragraphs.
Growing outrage today after basketball superstar LeBron James gets a police escort simply so he can get to a Justin Timberlake Jay-Z concert on time. So why did he get special treatment?
That's basketball superstar LeBron James boasting about a police escort taking him the wrong way down a one-way street just so he could get to a concert on time. He posted the video online and tweeted about his special treatment.
You guys came out there jumping on stage like idiots. Then y'all said we're gonna win 5 championships. You bought all this stuff on yourself. So don't act up, get on TV and act like the world owes you anything.
Now it's so sad to see an upper class city having this happiness. Then attack Eminem cause I rap this way. But I'm glad cause they feed me the fuel that I need for the fire to burn. And it's burning and I have returned and I am.
But I admit that I've made mistakes.
Now you're going to have to defend your title next year. And I just want you to know that LeBron James has already put his hand up for Texas.
Right now, I'm preliminary putting my name in the 2010 dunk contest on Saturday night.
How would you say you play in the NBA Finals?
Not great at all. Not the way I know how to play a game of basketball on a high level. You know, I'm out there to be a game changer, and I didn't make enough game-changing plays.
Were you not aggressive enough?
Just easy to look back and say, wow, I should have did it this way. Well, I should have been more aggressive. I just know I didn't play well. I could have played down the stretch better. I didn't
have enough game-changing plays like I know I'm capable of having. Plays where it just shifted the whole game. I don't remember having one of those plays in the finals.
How did that affect you personally?
Probably one of the hardest times of my life. You know, after the finals, I sat in my room for 2 weeks, did absolutely nothing, talked to absolutely nobody.
What'd you learn?
I got to this point by playing this game a certain way. You know, getting back to me loving the game and having fun with the game. I play the game fun and joyful, you know, and I let my game do all the talking, you know, and you know, I got away from that. Going through my first 7 years in the NBA, I was always the, you know, the liked one to be in, on the other side. You know, they called it the dark side or the villain, whatever they called it. It was definitely challenging for myself. It was a situation I'd never been in before. And it took a long time to adjust to it. You know, if I could look back on it, I would probably change a lot of it. You know, the fact that having the whole TV special and people get an opportunity to watch me make a decision on where I'm going to play.
As you said, you feel the hate. You sort of feel all this and people burning your jersey on TV.
Right.
What does that turn you into?
It basically turned me into somebody I wasn't. You know, I started to play the game of basketball at a level or at a mind state that I've never played at before. Being angry, you know, and that's mentally, and that's not the way I play the game of basketball. I'm not here to ask for any sympathy or ask for no apologies, letting people know who I am and who I am.
Now you can call him King James. Now you can call LeBron James MVP, because I witnessed him rise above his finals demons of a year ago, rise above these NBA finals, take them over for four straight games, and deserve without question the MVP. And whether anyone out there believes this or not, I am happy for LeBron James. I am relieved for LeBron James.
Watch this.
I have been saying on this show for 7 years, I like him personally. I think he's a good guy with a good heart. And I am here to say, I picked the Heat to win before the season. I picked him to win the finals. Heat win in five games because LeBron James ultimately made all the difference in the world. But I must say, big picture, I could not say it better than LeBron himself said it on ABC. It's about damn time.
The Miami Heat are once again NBA champions. LeBron James captures that elusive title he so desperately coveted.
The night and the series belong to your NBA champion, Miami Heat.
LeBron James, the seventh
congratulations. Go enjoy it.
I guess I could look back on a few instances in my life. I think growing up, without a father, not knowing sometimes if my mom would come home. My junior year in high school when I lost the state championship, and also losing the finals, it gave me an opportunity to learn who I am as a person and learn how to go forward.
So no more LeBron in the black villain hat?
No, I leave that to his game. His game can be the villain hat guy. But me personally, I'm not that guy.
This place will go absolutely crazy if he can get a bucket here.
Miami is only led by two early in the game. Wade, James for the lead. Over Pierce. That might be the dagger.
He's got 45.
A lot of catch up late in the streak. Roberts gives it away. Good read by Dwayne Wade. And it's LeBron James with 37-year-old Ray Allen. LeBron James. It'll be James. Same result.
Good job shrinking the floor by the Hornets right now. That's his only option. If he's making that, you just lose the game.
And it goes again. LeBron James on the triple. LeBron, man, is this guy hot. LeBron is amazing tonight. It'll be LeBron in rhythm. And another, LeBron James. Spectacular performance tonight. 8:20 and counting left in the half. And a 20-point lead thanks to 28 by LeBron.
What made him a champion?
Failure. Him sitting around and listening to us because he did. He watched Stephen A. He respects Stephen A. He knows what Stephen A says. And he had to sit there and take it.
Have you become braver, more fearless, any of that?
Yeah, I think so. You know, and I think it just comes from experience. You know, when you fall and you fail so many times, you just say,
you know, you kind of just look yourself in the mirror and say, well, you know, what are you going to do about it? You have all these other people around you, and yes, it's a team game, and yes, everything, you know, has to fall in place with the team, but what are you going to do to help things become different?
Have you changed, or have we changed?
No, I've changed. I've changed for the right, and I've grown as a basketball player. I've gotten better, and I've grown as a man. When you make mistakes, or you've done something that you didn't feel was the best choice to make, it's how you come back from adversity. It's how you come back from those pitfalls that define who you are as a man and as a professional athlete. At the hotel, these beautiful girls in dressing. And LeBron makes an incredible play. LeBron James from the floor, shut up, Cleveland. James, took a hard hit, put it in. Got a chance for a three-point play. James for three. Never tripping now. You're a mess! What the James! Tripping now because they were a shooter. Bring the heat on. What a block for James! Throws it back at Spurs. Ready to go. Too scared to steer. That's why I compete with legends. Motherfucking peers. Pulls up. Puts it in. 4-point lead. 35 for LeBron James.
The Miami Heat are going to be back-to-back champions.
But there can only be one. One winner of tonight's game, one winner of the NBA Finals, and one 2013 NBA champion, the back-to-back Miami Heat champions. Let's give them the trophy. The 2013 Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player is, for the second straight finals, LeBron James.
From the outside, scrutiny and pressure. How, when everybody is coming at you, do you keep your head and perform at the level you do?
Listen, for me, I can't worry about what everybody say about me. I'm LeBron James from Akron, Ohio, from the inner city. I'm not even supposed to be here. That's enough. Every night I walk into the locker room, I see a number 6 with James on the back. I'm blessed. So what everybody say about me off the court, don't matter. I ain't got no worries.
Congratulations, LeBron.
Congratulations to LeBron James for playing the greatest game of your career, LeBron James.
I gotta give credit where credit is due. LeBron James has cemented himself as one of the great, great players of all time.
Really heavy hardware, LeBron James. We're not gonna make you hold it for long, but there you go. Congratulations.
Thank you so
Number
much.
One, that's best NBA player and best championship performance.
you know, to be the leader that I am, to be composed throughout the game, no matter what the situation is at hand. And I give a lot of credit to my teammates for allowing me to take that role, you know, my coaching staff, and then me just maturing. Matured over the years, and it's allowed me to be in that position.
And when you look at the journey ahead and the stuff of Kobe and Michael Jordan, the three-peat opportunity on the horizon, what do you see as the biggest challenge to accomplishing that?
Well, our biggest challenge is going to be, you know, first our opponents. Each and every one of our opponents are going to continue to get better. And then we have to challenge ourselves. You know, we can't be content or complacent with winning, you know, two in a row. We have to be just as hungry as the first one or the second one and go out with that same intensity. Now, we have a great team. We have a great veteran team that loves to win. And then we have a great leader, and that's myself, that's driven by success. So I look forward to our next challenge. The success, it bleeds something into you, and it wants you. It allows me to want more, and you know, I'm looking forward to the next challenge. I'm not burnt out. I just seeing all the off-season trades and the off-season acquisitions and the new guys coming in, it just made me so excited to just, you know, get back into the locker room with the 14 guys and get ready for another title run.
I kind of know how things move. You know, I know how professional everything is. Not to say anybody else isn't, but I just know how everything moves. I know that everybody cares, and it's good to see familiar faces. And this is what I wanted to do ever since I was a little kid, and my family and friends know I wanted to get back out there and give it another shot, and I'm here.
And if we feel that we know how to win this year, we don't. That was last year, and at some point, all the way leading up to opening night, we're going to have to let that go. Let last year's championship go, as gratifying as it was. This is a new challenge, and we don't know how.
No season is easy. You're trying to three-peat back-to-back. You're trying to win a championship. I think we're a mentally strong team, and I think we understand the team that we have and understand that this is a once-in-a-lifetime, you know, opportunity for us.
So, Isaiah, what impact do these fallen stars have on the Heat this year?
Huge impact if they're healthy. They understand their scheme and their system right now better than most teams. And this is a perfect spot for Beasley, and I'm really happy for Obi.
These guys will help them survive a regular season. And if at some point they do retain their health, maybe Odin brings that size they need in the Eastern Conference against the Pacers, Roy Hibbert. So the size has been missing in the past for them. Maybe Odin adds that.
I'm LeBron James from Akron, Ohio, from the inner city. I'm not even supposed to be here.
It ain't over! It ain't over till LeBron says it's over. LeBron for three. Come on!
And that's the predicament James puts you in, though. Because he's such a great and unwilling passer, they would be better off with Bill Cowher guarding LeBron James in this situation.
Kelly gets the foul, and James the chance for the three-point play.
Nice pass, Wade. Yes, and the foul. 16 seconds left. LeBron turns it off.
Waiting and seeing on Paul George. And last night, I must tell you very strongly, I saw a bona fide MVP candidate.
Sure, they won a championship. Sure, they want to win. But you almost get the impression that that it won't be as sweet unless they take Miami to do it.
We don't like them, but they don't like us. It's nothing more to explain. I mean, it's not like it's unheard of. I mean, or unheard of. We all know what it is. They don't like us, so we don't like them.
While I'm playing the game of basketball, I like to be that villain. You know, when you come in, when I go into a building, I want people to fear me. I want, you know, people to fear us as a team, and, you know, I accept it.
Soon as you release, call a brother peace.
Hello.